My coach Hayes, you know, I call him my uncle. He introduced, you know, put the basketball in my hands. I was strictly a football player and never had no intentions on playing basketball until, you know, one day he said, you should come play. You know, you should come try out and, you know, see how you like it.
Coach Jay, my partner, he was like, I got a kid for you. I said, yeah. I said, all right, who is he? Say, yo, his kid's gonna be all right. Now he's playing football now. He's a football kid. Got him in the gym, and I'm like, whoa, hold up. This kid's all right, you know. First thing I seen was his athleticism. He's too athletic to really play on the box. I gotta get this kid some wiggle. And then from there, that's where we took off.
When I was choosing between basketball and football, you know, it was hard. You know, I wasn't 100% sure what I wanted to do because usually all the time, every time it was time to play basketball, I missed football. Every time it's time to play football, I missed basketball. But me being interested in Montverde, that pretty much, you know, settled it for me. It's like, all right, you're going to go to Montverde, you're going to focus on what they have, which is basketball. You're just going to get better at it, you know, keep getting better and be the best you can be.
Dariq was badass at football, like phenomenal. Like people was probably recruiting him in fifth grade. But Dariq loved basketball, and he wasn't good. It wasn't until this one game, it was a championship game for football, and he chose to go to a basketball tournament where I was like, ah, he really loves basketball.
What has it been, bro? I was going for like 4 weeks, so it's been about a month. I was going for 4 weeks.
But yeah, man, it's to see how focused he's been. All these years, all the pressure, especially in the city, you know, just getting pulled in every direction and still like staying the course, and that alone is, he's already a professional, you know what I'm saying? Especially like how he's conducting his business, you know what I'm saying? He's got a good support system.
Man, I gotta get ready for this. There we go. I had to get ready for that one. Last time I said, caught me off guard. Right now we're in 15th Street and South 17th Street. You know, we're in Newark, New Jersey. That's where it all started at. You know, that's where everything happened. This right here is the, you know, the corner store I grew up coming to, you know, house that I grew up in right across the street. So, you know, this was, you know, we needed snacks, anything we ran right here to get, you know, it's where everything, you know, they took care of us in this store right here. Oh, they still got that thing up?
Let's try it right here.
I didn't know they still had that up right here.
Right here.
By the stairs right here. And then my brother right here. I can honestly say my brother had the biggest influence on me. You know, since me being a kid, I always wanted to be like him. You know, when I was a little younger, you know, he made it to the pros, was a football player, and that's something I always look forward to. You know, just being in a pro, being able to take care of my family, you know, show kids and know that, you know, it's still a way to make it, no matter, you know, the critics you hear, you know, people gonna say stuff about you. And that was really just my biggest, you know, my biggest influence. I always wanted to be like him. You know, he pushed me every day to go harder and just pushed me to be who I am today.
So growing up, we were always a football family, and you know, I played football because our older brother and, you know, Dariq, he got into it because of, you know, we were into football, and that's the way it was. You know, we didn't know, you know, anything else, and like, you know, our older brother, he played basketball, baseball, all of these other sports, but the primary focus was football. You know, he played both. You know, he was tall, you know, he was young, he was tall, so he had the frame to play basketball. Then football is almost like he got too tall. It came down to him making the decision as to which route he wanted to travel when he was going to Mount Bird, when he had that option. And he loved football. He really almost didn't want to go to Mount Bird for the fact that he was going to have to stop playing and they didn't have a team. So he was like, he had a decision to make, and ultimately you see the decision he made, and it worked out for him.
Because I've never
been into watching basketball. My older sons play football. I'm a football mom. That's all in my mind, football. So I started going to the games, and it was just like amazing hearing the crowd around me and the spectators all talk about my son and how good he was in this game they call basketball.
The biggest challenge was Mount Verd. He had, you know, that was like a no say. We knew he needed to go to that school. Being away from home, eighth grade, he was the youngest to go to, you know, Mount Verd at that time and play varsity. I think it was a challenge. He was the neighborhood, you know, hero, as they would call him, you know, played everywhere. Everybody wanted to see him play. Now for him to go to Mount Verd in eighth grade and not play, that was a challenge. He cried every day, called every day. And here goes Quad, my son need to come home. They not playing my son. Didn't understand the process, but I knew it was gonna be where we are today.
You know, just being away from my family, you know, I was so used to being with them every day, so used to them doing things for me. And just going down there, it was like a, you know, rude awakening. You know, I had to wash my own clothes. I had to be on my own, you know, learn how to, you know, just basically survive on my own, you know, when to eat, you know, and stuff like that, just time management. So I could definitely say that was one of the hardest decisions I ever made, but I'm happy, you know, I did make the decision. You know, it made me into the person I am today. Right now, yeah, my old middle school. I went here fifth through eighth grade before I went to Mount Verd. You know, this where I could, you know, this where I started, this where everything started off at. You know, this where I started to, you know, grow up and become the person I am. You know, everything. And my teachers helped me with that. You know, I got Ms. Burke here, Ms. Henderson. You know, they all helped me with that.
It's very challenging, you know, trying to raise a child here, trying to raise children here, rather, with all the madness going on, all the crime, and you know, you just have to keep your kid focused. You have to take them outside of the box, and with Dariq, that's always what I've done. I've always found things. I've always watched the kids he played with, the situation, the events he went to. I just made sure I kept him in good situations.
Hey, look. Whew. Nah, I ain't play no basketball in high school. I just ball up, you feel me? I just go out there and do what I do, you feel me? But look, I put up buckets on. You know,
this is not at all. Winning.
See, I wasn't prepared.
Hey, look,
you just called
just
me out.
Recap.
What did I do?
A couple months ago, I beat him in football too.
No, you didn't. You lied.
I ain't beat you in football.
No.
I ain't beat you in football.
Next year, I'll be attending Duke University. The main thing that stuck out to me was how, you know, united they are and how close the coaches are with the kids. You know, when I was there, we done been to, I think, two different coaches' house, and all the kids, they made sure all the kids, you know, got dressed, got off campus and was there. And then just to see how, you know, not just the coaches, but their wives was interacting with the kids, making sure they were good, you know, making sure they ate, make sure they had snacks in, the, you know, their room and stuff like that. I feel like that's the biggest thing, you know, if I'm going away from my mother, just to have people who gonna look out and make sure you good when my mom is not there. That stood out to me the most. So beginning the new era with Coach Shire, you know, I feel like Duke is gonna remain the same. You know, it's still gonna be Duke. You know, nothing's gonna change but the coach. And I feel like, you know, he's a coach that can come in and get a job now.
Oh, they're getting a monster. I mean, they're getting a humble beast. Like, Dariq is the most humble kid that I know. He has a lot of, like, you know, talk around him, a lot of fame around him, a lot of different things, but no one would ever know because Dariq doesn't care about those things. He's always caring about his community. He's always caring about his teammates, but they're getting someone that is ready to come in and shine immediately.
He's always been a humble kid, so I didn't really care about that, you know what I mean? Because he'd do anything for the team. He's not selfish at all.
I think they're getting a star, a great person, you know, and honestly a baller, man. Like, just a guy with that killer instincts that's gonna go out there and make it all happen.